Welcome to the Book of Unwritten Tales, I'm your host Lostwolfe, and this is episode 15, and we have the goggles, let's head out of here. The first thing that we're going to do is go due right of where we are now. And here we have Ivo.
Hello, Ivo.
Have you worked out a way to get me into the upper town yet?
Yes.
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
We sure have. It's heading upstairs. Okay, so there is... have we got the rope? Have the rope. There is a pulley here.
Good idea.
And up Ivo comes.
You've already kept that promise once before.
Of course.
But what's with this oh-so-important message, then?
Come with me to the Mage Tower. I'll show you there.
Hurry, or none of us will be in control of our own destinies. Help us, Master Alistair. You're our only hope.
This is not good at all.
Now do you understand? We have to do something. If the Archmage hasn't returned soon, we have to find the island's location using the book and then rescue the artifact ourselves.
You're right. We have to do something. No mortal should be in possession of such power. I'm in.
Yay! And there's an airship moored right outside. Maybe Cap and Nate will fly us to the island.
One thing at a time. First, we have to find out where this island is.
Okay, so in the upper left-hand corner, you can now see that we have portraits. Currently, the colored one is us, so we are currently in control of Ivo. And the grayscale one is... we're in control of Wilbur. The grayscale one is the person we're not in control of. If we click on them... Wilbur will go idle somewhere, and now I'm in control of Ivo. So there's a couple of parchments here that we can grab.
There are several large pieces of paper on top of the bookcase. Could possibly be maps.
Wilbur, of course, couldn't reach these. We look at them.
It's the Gremlin's book that I got from his secret cellar. There's a description of how to reach the island of Sordia in it. Okay, now, what do we have here? A story about a magician and his sheep.
Oh, a story about mages, with pictures.
You won't like this story, believe me. Here, this is the travel log of a fairy explorer. In it, he describes how he landed on an island. He sketched the temple ruins.
And the professor believes that the artifact is in this temple on the island of Sordia.
Exactly. The fairy explorer described his route very precisely.
Never heard of it.
Me neither. We have to find it.
Okay, so let's go back to being Wilbur. There was this book over here that we hadn't really explored. Or we had explored, but we couldn't see anything in.
The strange thing is that most of the pages are completely blank. I mean, our world isn't that uninteresting.
And so to look at the pages, we need the glasses.
Incredible! Now I have the glasses on. The pages are filled from top to bottom with fine script. Without the glasses, the pages appear totally empty. So the glasses are as useful as they are cool. What should I look for?
Sordia, Alistair the Archmage? Surely not. Let's look for Alistair.
I found him less charming than I'd expected. Probably important leaders don't have time to be polite. Adelaide of Sad Hills, Alabaster Processing, Alistair the Shrink, Alistair the Third of High... here we are. Alistair Mordred Michael Mechtild, Archmage. Blah, blah, born the second of four children, brother Marku, blah, blah, Mage Academy, summa cum laude. Order of Merlin, first class, level 99 Archmage, blah, blah, work on sheep, metamorphosis, owner of some of the world's most powerful magical artifacts, blah, blah, head of the Alliance Secret Service, advisor to the king, blah, blah. Strange. Why does it always say blah, blah? You'd think the authors would take more care with the entry for someone that important.
Okay, so now that we found him, we can bail out by saying, ah, surely not. Let's go look for Sordia.
Let's see what we can find. Sauron, Semelina, Shyster, Sordia, an island located in the Silent Sea, probably named after a long-forgotten sorcerer. That's all it says. No information as to where the island actually is. Pretty skimpy.
Sordia is a little bit, or reminds me a little bit of Sword of the Sorcerer from my friend.
It was worth a try.
Legend of Kyandia.
Hello, Evo.
What's up?
How would it be if you took over from here and see you then? This means that you can change without having to hit over there.
I have to think a minute. Could you take over here?
Of course.
And so now, of course, she is in control.
That's the Encyclopedia Fantastica, a torrid attempt to squeeze all the world's knowledge between two book covers.
Okay. Let's look at the map real quickly.
Right then, Krunpak, where are you? I don't believe this. I just can't find the place.
Me neither. It isn't on the map.
But why would this fairy explorer describe a place that doesn't exist? Or did it once exist but is now abandoned?
That's it.
Hmm?
Krunpak is the name of the place in the Shades language. When the fairy explorer was there, it was a shade town. But this map is new, so it'll have the human name of the town.
So we have to find out what the town of Krunpak used to be called?
Exactly.
Right, so let's do that. And since we have the encyclopedia here, it's fairly easy.
Okay. What should I look for?
Krunpak.
Alright, I just hope the encyclopedia is more up to date than the map. Kedgeri Kayak, Kedgeri Kismet, Krunabel the Terrible, Krunpak. Krunpak, once known as Redstonbury, is a town in the southern heath, known mainly for its salt mining and the blah blah blah. Redstonbury, this is it.
And the blah blah blah. Amazing. Let's head back over to the map now that we've got our footing.
So, Redstonbury, where are you?
This is a thing I do not like. So what you have to do, first of all, is you have to find Redstonbury, which is fairly easy. Redstonbury is due north. And now you have to follow directions, but the directions, as written, had me very confused, which is why I didn't record this game for a long time, because I was frustrated with this map. There are two puzzles in this game I don't like. This is one of them. Anyway, so we find Redstonbury.
There it is! Redstonbury.
Excellent. From there, we have to follow the footsteps of the fairy explorer. There are 7 steps in total. I'll read them out, and you look where it takes us, okay? Good. We're in Redstonbury. The first point is 2 days' march north to the foot of the mountains. Where's that? Mark the place. Okay, from there, 1 day's march eastwards. The place has to be somewhere on a large plain. Next step, go northeastwards until you reach the road. You got it? Follow the road in a northerly direction until you reach a river. The next marker goes where the road meets the river. Follow the river to its mouth. That's good. Now head south. Follow down the coast until you reach a large bay. East of the bay, there should be islands. Mark the bay. Okay, From there, head northeast. It's the second island along. You got it?
That must be the Isle of Sordia right there.
Good work. I don't think that we've made a mistake. So that over there is Sordia. We need a smaller map that we can take with us. We can mark the island on that.
Right. Good idea.
So, when I was originally recording this, I had the steps of that way out of balance, and I was going way too far in any given direction. And I ended up somewhere like way down south, which didn't really help. So, we have got our map now.
There are several large pieces of paper on top of the bookcase. Could possibly be maps.
Oh. Did she not get them? Ivo, did you not get them? Oh, you didn't.
No problem. That looks like a tactical map to me. There are troop movements marked on it. Presumably that was years ago. One of the maps is a rough copy of the map on the wall. Excellent. I'll mark the island of Sordia.
So, now we've found the island, all we need is some transportation.
And that is floating outside.
You got it.
Okay, so we now have the map. Sorry, I thought we had the map, but we didn't.
The island of Sordia is marked on the map. Now we know where the journey needs to take us.
Okay, so we've got everything we need. Let's head out.
Orcs are tough, strong, and aggressive. That one there looks fit. I don't know if I could eliminate her. If at all, it would be with speed. Or with brains.
So, let's see if we can arm wrestle or something like that.
What do you want, elf?
I have to borrow the human for a few days. So, how does the contest sound? See you soon, Orc.
I need the human for a few days. Will you lend him to me?
No, I'm carrying out a task and I'll fulfill it.
Then I'll take him.
If you can get past me.
Meow.
Shut it, Nate.
There's never a mud wrestling pit when you need it most.
Do you really think that you have a ghost of a chance against Mazaz?
Perhaps so. Who or what is a Mazaz?
Who are you?
I am Mazaz.
Is that a strapping master swordsman that you've got locked up there? I need him.
Hey, marry me, elf.
I want that human, and I'll have him before sundown.
Ooh, elfie.
I'm looking forward to seeing how you're going to achieve that, elf.
Let's get out of here.
Dork.
I hope not.
I think we've talked to Nate. It's been a long, long time.
Hello,
but let's
human.
Just do that.
Hello, my lovely.
Why did they take you prisoner?
Why have you been captured? What do you stand accused of?
I'd like to know that too. I'm a harmless adventurer.
Exactly. It's just some dumb coincidence that most of your adventures happen to be illegal, right?
If you're involved with illegal activities, then you should be punished.
Well, he will be now.
I don't think anybody deserves what's about to happen to me.
What? Has the prospect of torture finally shut your fat gob?
I just think that nobody deserves spending 3 days alone with you on an airship, that's all.
I've had enough. Farewell.
You'll be back. They all come back.
And that's his friend Critter.
I've never seen a creature like that before. It's similar to the demon from the inn. Maybe it's just an animal.
I find it strange that Warba gave that assessment, but sure. Let's talk to Mazaz.
Hello, Orc.
What do you want, elf?
How does a contest sound?
How about this little competition? Elf against Orc. It'll be a classic.
As long as it's not going to be about who can best howl at the moon by a swamp, then the result is a given.
What about dental care, general education, or thunderous thighs?
Shut it, Nate.
I agree.
So, what do you suggest?
ballet dance, arm wrestling, a running race. Maybe a contest wasn't such a good idea after all. That bails us out, of course. Let's pick the ones that don't work.
We could have a race?
Not that I wouldn't win, but it strikes me as a little risky to leave my quarry with your short-assed accomplice. Scared? Suggest something that we can do here. Then you'll see that I fear nothing, much less you.
Okay, so a running race ain't gonna work.
How about with a bit of ballet?
I knew it. Only a young elf weed could suggest something like that.
Young elf? I was here even before you orcs were invented.
Then you should possess some kind of skills that go beyond dancing around a bit. So, what do you suggest?
So ballet dancing isn't gonna work. Let's try arm wrestling.
You think that you're strong, so how about a bit of arm wrestling?
You are joking, aren't you? An elf beating an orc warrior at arm wrestling? Never!
So, are you willing to give it a shot?
Of course. Why not? Come here. Okay, let's do it. Hey, elf. I said let's do it. Let me know when you're ready. Shall we warm up? Right. I'm ready. Shall we start?
Huh.
What's the matter? Fed up already?
Okay, so our solution to this problem lies with Wilbur, of course. So how do you actually get past the town guards? How'd it be if you took over from here?
The town guard will only let mages and people with prior invitations up there. Looking at your clothes, my guess is that you pretended to be a mage.
I'm not pretending to be a mage. I am a mage, with a diploma.
I find it quite difficult to believe that a young gnome from the White Ridge Mountains is a mage.
But it's true. I did the training with Master Marcus down in the city.
You learn everything that one needs to know for the mage diploma in a few hours.
Aye. Wasn't easy, though. Almost killed me.
That's not wrong.
Enough said. Let's move.
Right.
Okay, so what we need to do is she wants to arm wrestle, but she's not strong enough. So we made an elixir of strength, our power elixir. Let's give that to Ivo.
Here, Ivo, a power elixir. Maybe you can use it.
Thank you.
Right, so let's switch back to Ivo. And since we're trying to arm wrestle, let's drink our potion.
I just have to be careful Cheep Cheep doesn't get wind of this. He'd tell on me at home. I can't feel anything. I wonder if it worked.
Try the arm wrestling again.
Hello, Orc.
What do you want, Elf?
How about another round of arm wrestling?
Now, there's someone who likes to be humiliated. I will flatten you.
We'll see about that. This time I'm playing for real.
Of course!
Right, so now while they're arm wrestling, there's a couple of things that we need to do. Let's put our net in a plank. We need to get our rope again. I forgot that didn't immediately end.
Yes.
Magic! There's magic at play here.
An elf would never cheat, as well you know.
I want revenge!
Perhaps some other time.
I didn't get that done in time. Okay. So, while that's happening, let me get the rope. I want to get my rope. There we go.
Got it.
And we're going to tie our rope to the net on the floor. I don't think I can reach there now. Yeah, I don't think I can reach there right now. I can sort of get it set up, though.
That won't work. The bounty hunter would notice.
Yes. Oh, okay. Alright, well, let's do our revenge. I forget that you have to be fast with that.
Hello, Orc.
What do you want, elf?
Okay.
So, another round of arm wrestling?
You were just lucky. I wasn't concentrating.
Of course.
And now that they're doing that, let's do what we need to get done.
First, I'll throw the rope over that crossbeam.
Very good. And now we need to tie the rope. To the net.
That looks like a good trap to me.
Okay, we should be done.
The bumpkin has to walk onto the plank first, otherwise all that work will have been in vain.
Yes. So let's wait.
Yes.
Magic! There's magic at play here.
An elf would never cheat, as well you know.
I want revenge!
Perhaps some other time.
Agreed. So, now the trap is all set.
I can't do it.
Okay.
Oi, what's going on?
Ivor!
What the?
Now!
Oops. That wasn't supposed to happen.
Well, hey, that was brilliant. Get us out of here.
Okay.
Hello.
Hi down there. Mizaz's departure was a little abrupt.
Yes, somehow I always have problems with the fine-tuning on my traps.
Main thing is, she's gone.
Ivo and I have to travel to a certain island as quickly as possible. Will you take us there?
What's going on there, then?
Oh, it's an archaeological expedition.
Oh, right.
You owe us that, Nate. We've rescued you from certain death.
Oh, yeah, I'd have worked something out myself. And, my pretty one, to you, I'm Captain Bonnet. I'm not interested in a scientific expedition.
Okay, then we'll leave you hanging up here till the bounty hunter gets back. Ah, great. It's about official quest from the Alliance. It's about... No, I can't tell you. Let's pick the ones that won't work, of course.
If you don't want to help us, then just stay up there till the bounty hunter comes back. And what do you think the Green Lady's gonna do to you when she does get back?
You've got a point there. On the other hand, you still need my airship. And do you know how to steer a flying ship?
Okay, isn't gonna work. Ah, great, and some unofficial quest from the Alliance.
The Archmage himself has sent us on a mission.
The Archmage? I'm not so sure I want to get myself dragged into this.
But this is vital to the Alliance.
I'm not on the Alliance's side. Of course, I'm not on the Shadow Army's side either. I'm a neutral. I leave them alone, they leave me alone.
Capturing you and wanting to kill you is something that you call leaving you alone.
Well, put it this way. I'd prefer not to attract quite so much attention from now on. Mazaz is going to come after me again, and it's not really appropriate for me to be going into war waving a banner for the Alliance.
Okay, so it's about... No, I can't tell you.
Well, it's about this... thing.
This thing? And you don't want to tell me what this thing is? Are you scared I'll go off looking for it myself? Is it that valuable?
Well, actually...
Yes.
Ah, and where is it exactly?
On an island. We'll show you when we're in the air.
Well, I reckon for 50%.
But you're alone.
There's two of us, just like you two.
You're counting your pet as well.
Well, you have.
Hey!
A third. You fly us there and then stay out of the way once we've arrived.
Okay, fine, we're in. Now will you get us down at last? Everything okay with you guys?
Yes, this must be the entrance to the temple. How long do you think it'll take to repair the engine?
Oh, it's more complicated than it seemed. You shouldn't wait for me.
Ooh, how exciting! A sunken temple full of danger and adventure, a lost artifact, and we are the valiant treasure hunters hot on the trail.
Listen, Wilbur, you did really well in Seastone, but this is different. Things could get really dangerous here. I prefer if you stayed out of this.
But...
I'll call you if I need you, okay?
But...
He's gonna hate me for that. But I'd rather have an insulted gnome to deal with than a dead one.
And that's it. That's us for today. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been episode 15 of my friend, Book Unwritten Tales. I hope you're enjoying it as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening. And good night for now, folks.